In this video, we will consider multiple capacitors in series. Throughout, keep in mind the basic equation for capacitance. Capacitance, capital C, is the proportionality constant for a capacitor between charge and voltage. In previous videos, we have covered how changes in electric potential, known as voltage, create charge separation given a source of electromotive force. Also, previously, we have explored the simple example of a single pair of parallel conducting plates and how, manipulating their properties, we can change capacitance, which will influence the behavior of the circuit. Now we will consider the case of connecting up capacitors one after the other. This is known as a series connection. In this example, we have two capacitors represented by pairs of charged plates. A defining law governing circuits is the conservation of charge. Charges may be separated, but neither created nor destroyed. This means, when considering capacitance for each of the elements, if they are connected sequentially along the same path, the charge separation must be the same. This implies that depending on capacitance, each element will have different voltage drop across it. However, keep in mind that the total voltage drop across the entire circuit must still equal that provided by our source of electromotive force. Along a series path, the voltage must add up. We will now use these equations to derive an equivalent capacitance for the entire circuit. Total voltage equals the voltage of the first element plus the voltage of the second element. We factor out Q and rearrange the equation in a standard form, where now we can read off the proportionality constant that will be our equivalent capacity. We can now use these to back calculate the voltage drop across each element. Let's put this mathematical theory to the test in the capacitor lab by PhET simulations. Choose multiple capacitors. Enable the calculation of total capacitance and stored charge. And we will also need the voltmeter. Let's start with two capacitors in series. Let's create a voltage, which will create the charge separation across each capacitor. You can now check the mathematics for equivalent capacitance and stored charge. For example, for equivalent capacitance, we have two capacitors, each with 0.1 picofarads. You can now verify that plugging these into our expression will result in the calculated total capacitance by the simulator. Let's check voltage. First, across the entire circuit, which should equal that given by our source of electromotive force. Note that the voltage across each capacitor is less than this. Their sum, however, must still add up to the total voltage of the circuit. Now let's check the circuit for unequal capacitances. Notice again that if you plug in the new values for capacitance into our derived equation, we can verify the total capacitance of the system. Let's check the voltage again to verify that the total drop is still equivalent to that of our battery. The voltage drop across each capacitor is now different. But their sum is still that given by the voltage of the whole circuit. As always, feel free to play around with the simulator, trying three capacitors in series, always checking the mathematics, and measurements, including for capacitances that are not the same. Throughout, remember that when confronting more than two elements, you can always first calculate an equivalent capacitance for them before combining them into a single capacitance to be combined then again with a third one. This will prove important when we combine series plates with ones that are parallel.